Alright, so let's switch back to Selenium. In the last section, we have gone through Python basics, and I think that was good amount of information we have gained, and using that information, now let's come back to our Selenium module. So you will not come across much Python programming in this complete Selenium module. So once we start designing framework, there you will come across all the topics what we have learnt in the last section. So in this module, we will mostly concentrating on Selenium APIs and how would we automate our web browsers. Okay, so once Selenium knowledge is complete and when we move to framework section, there you will get all the Python object oriented concepts like classes, functions, dictionaries, tuples. We will use all of them, don't worry. Alright, so I just created one new package, Python Selenium, so that all our test cases now will be part of this package for this specific module. It's easy for us to create package, right click new and Python package, that's it. So under this package, now I will have new Python file. And let's start our test with demo browser. So in this file, let us see on how to invoke the browser and how to hit our first program using Selenium with Python. Okay. So first things first, you have to invoke browser. That is the first point, right? Before you automate anything. So how would you do that in Python? So you have a class called WebDriver dot. So move your cursor on this, and here WebDriver is a package and this exposes multiple classes. Okay, so when you move your cursor, it will ask to import this name and you need to import selenium.webdriver. So that's the base package. From this package, when you say dot, you will get all the different browsers it have in that specific package. So let's start with Chrome browser first. You need to select this class, Chrome class. Make sure you select the class which have capital letter, okay? WebDriver dot Chrome. And you have to create object out of this class when you call that class. And that's it. This is the driver object. Using this object, now you will automate your complete browser. Okay, so this is the first and mandatory step required for all your test cases if you want to invoke this in Chrome browser. Okay, so I will show how to invoke that in Firefox and Internet Explorer in our next lectures. So let's actually make sure we open the browser and hit some URL in that and see how that goes. And one thing you have to remember, every browser exposes an executable file. Okay, so Selenium do not have direct access to invoke Chrome browser in an automated mode. Okay, so you can simply open the browser in your local system, but if you want to open a browser which in automated mode so that it should listen the incoming request from your test, okay, that privilege Selenium do not have directly. So what happened is every browser now, like Chrome, Firefox, IE or Safari, all these guys have exposed one executable file. Okay, through Selenium you need to first invoke that executable file which is given by that browser team. So that executable file is responsible to invoke a browser in an automated mode. Okay, so browser gives one executable file and throw Selenium test, we need to invoke the executable file. Which will then invoke actual browser. Okay, this file is responsible to invoke our actual browser. Okay, so you have to give the path of that executable file in this parenthesis. Okay, you need to simply say executable path. You see that when you type three letters, you will get suggestion. Executable path equals to, and you need to give the path to that file. But where is that file present? For that, visit their official website, selenium.dev. So this is the website where you will have all Selenium libraries and their support browser drivers to download. Okay, so scroll down and you will see browsers. Right, so in this browsers, now we are interested in getting the Chrome browser driver. So go to the Chrome section and select the documentation link here. It clearly says that Chrome driver is supported by Chromium project. So if you want to download that Chrome driver, you have to visit their official website where you will land here. Based upon the version you have to download that specific Chrome driver exe file. So make sure what browser version you have. Right now today it's 79. By the time you are watching, it could be 100 because Chrome releases browser versions frequently. Okay. So download that specific driver. You just need to hit this link and that will eventually open this page. If you are working on Mac, then you need to download this. And if you are working on Windows, you can use this Win32. No matter if you have 64-bit or 32-bit, you can still download this. So once you download this, you will get in zip format. And when you extract this zip file, you will see something like this. There will be .exe file will be there when you extract. Make sure you extract it. Don't go to that folder by in zip format. You have to unzip it first and then carefully copy this .exe file and put it in any desired location, because you need to pass the path of that specific location. So right now I have my Chrome driver in just directly at C drive. Okay, so you can put it anywhere. So I will take the path. I'll go back to my test and I will simply give C:// after I unzipped and extracted that this is the .exe file, Chrome driver .exe. Okay, you will get this in two specific folders. Remove, take it from there and put it in proper place. Alright, that's it. So you have successfully given that path of that specific driver, and that's all you need to do. And when you run this test, automatically first this file will be invoked and that will eventually invoke your Chrome browser, and that overall access of your browser is given to this driver object. Using this driver, now you will start playing with your browser. Okay, so all the capabilities and knowledge of that Chrome browser which is opened have known by this driver object now. So with this driver object, now if you want to hit any URL on the browser which got opened, then there is a method called get. So get is a method which will help you to hit the URL in the browser. Okay. Now let me take to my website rahulshettyacademy.com. So right now this website is in under construction. By the time you watch this video, I think that will be live, because we are bringing up so many exciting updates like automation trainings, job support and practice web pages and freelancing jobs for QA technical people and a lot of things. So now we want to land on this web page. So let me take this URL rahulshettyacademy.com and I would put it here. That's it. So when I run this test, the browser should invoke, and I told you that this specific get method will help you to hit URL on browser. So it hits that and we should land on that page. So right click and you say run the demo browser, because that is the file, and let's see how that goes. You see that Chrome browser is successfully open and you landed on rahulshettyacademy.com. Great, awesome. So this is your first program in Selenium Python. Congratulations. And here is the way where now we will go and explore and do a lot of things. Nice. So you landed on that web page, right? Now if you want to know title of that web page. Now for example, if you move your cursor on that specific web page, you will see here a world leader in software testing. Okay, that's the title of this web page. If you want to know what is the title of that web page, you can do it from your Selenium test. You need to simply say driver.title. This method will extract the title of the web page which got opened. And if you want to see it in the output, you have to simply say print so that you can see the title of that web page in the console. Okay. Similarly, you have to know whether you landed on this web page or not. Okay, so these days, you know, cyber attacks are most common things which are happening. And when you try to hit this web page, you will be redirected to some another page if it is hacked. So one common thing which we will use in every basic test is to verify whether we landed in the correct URL what we are expecting or not. So for that, there is a method called driver.currentURL. So that gives the current URL which is now present on that browser. So when you land on this web page and when you say get me the current URL, it should be obviously the URL what you have used if my website is not hacked. If it is hacked, then you may see some different website. So let me know if you see something different so that I can alert my developers. All right. Now, I will run this test again. Run demo browser. Let's see what comes this time. Okay. And if you go back and you see, the title is printed, Rahul Shetty Academy, a world leader in software testing, trainings and consulting. Okay, that's the title. And next, you see that URL is also printed and it's rahulshettyacademy.com. So this is what you entered and this is what you got. Perfect. So that means there is no hacking. Okay, so right now we are printing it in the console. In upcoming lectures, I will tell you how to put assertion on this. Okay, so let's not get into all topics at this moment. So now we were trying to understand how to invoke browser and how to get title and the URL of that browser. Now, after I run the test, you see that browser is still in open mode. If I want to close it, what to do? It should get closed automatically. Okay, so in that case, driver dot close. So close is a method which will help you to close the browser which got invoked at this step so that it runs all your execution and it gets closed. That's where driver.close is being used. And there is one more method called driver.quit. So that also does the same, but the difference is, so in our upcoming lectures, we might end up opening multiple windows through our automated code. Let's say you click on one link in rahulshettyacademy.com and that will open another page. Okay, now it is opened in the same window. So if it is opened in another window completely like this, that means there are two windows opened, right? So in that case, when you say driver.quit, all the windows will get closed. But when you say driver.close, only current window will get closed where your control is. So when you select some link on parent window, another window will get opened, right? If you are working on that child window and when you say driver.close, that child window only will get closed. Okay. But in this case, there is only one window which is open. So obviously close or quit doesn't matter. As there is only one window, both does same. But if there are multiple windows and if you want to close all them, then use quit. Don't worry, I will explain how to handle this parent and child windows in our later sections. Okay, So now when I run this test, it should do all the validations, and at the end, browser should get closed. Let's see. Awesome. You see that? No browser. It got closed. So that's your basic test where we want to start from. In our next lecture, let's continue the same. Thank you.